Hi, today we're going to make a Minnie Mouse birthday tutu dress. To make this dress, you're going to need hot pink tulle and light pink tulle. I have 6-inch rolls here. A metallic marker. You'll need some rhinestones. Any size will do. You'll need black felt, or I'm using this black sparkly fabric material that I got from Hobby Lobby. It's next to the felt in the felt section. And a crochet headband. I'm using hot pink. You'll need a Mickey or Minnie Mouse head template. I just printed mine from Google Images, and some 1.5-inch ribbon. I'm cutting out my Mickey Mouse head template. I just printed it on regular copy paper. And I'm going to trace that onto the back of this black sparkly material here. You could use just regular black felt or zebra felt or any other type of material you'd like to use. As long as it's pretty flexible and you're able to cut it easily. Now I'm using my metallic marker to write the number 3, but you could write a letter if you'd like to, an initial, or you can do a full name if you'd like to. I'm tracing around the number 3 with a hot glue gun, and I'm attaching the rhinestones with tweezers. Make sure you use tweezers so that you don't burn your fingers, and make sure all the pieces are secure. Now I'm eyeballing about how big I'd like the Minnie Mouse ribbon, the hair bow to be. And I'm heat sealing the ends so that it doesn't fray. And now I am rolling out the tulle. I decided that I wanted an 8-inch skirt, so I'm cutting the tulle at about 19 inches here. And just keep cutting, you'll need quite a bit. So I've got a nice little stack to start with. I actually ended up cutting about 3 more times. So I've applied the crochet headband to the mannequin, and now I'm adding the tulle. I use 3 pieces at a time because I feel like it makes the tutu full without having to go around the dress 3 times. I just do it all at once and fluff it. I know that you can do up to 4. I've never done 5. You could, but it seems like it would be a little more difficult, and you don't want to tear the crochet headband. But you could try it. Okay, so now I'm going to speed things up a bit, and I'll go all around the tutu until it is complete. Then when I have all the pieces on and the skirt is full or finished, I'll go through and fluff it. There I'm just trimming off a piece that looked a little too long. So now you can see how fluffy that is, and I'm just measuring how long I want my straps to be. So I'm going to cut 2 equal pieces in the length that I chose, and I'm going to heat seal the ends so that the ribbon doesn't fray. Now what I'm doing is I'm pulling the pieces through 2 holes at the top part of the crochet tutu, or with the crochet headband. And I'm just going to glue the 1 piece over top of itself, if that makes sense. You probably can see it better than I can tell you. But there you have 1 strap. inserting the second piece, and I'm just going to fold it over on itself. And now I have two straps attached. I'm just going to pull them behind the dress. And now I'll pull each strap through a hole in the back of the dress. This will allow the straps to tie in the back. And this is exactly how you would tie the dress onto a child. Okay, so this is what we have so far. Now what we're going to do is we're going to add the mini head to the dress. And we're just going to attach this mini head by using hot glue all around the back side of our applique or our mini head. And you want to use enough glue so that it sticks to the crochet headband, but not so much glue that it's seeping through the crochet headband, because it'll dry and it'll be itchy on a child. Also, if you'd like a little extra coverage under this kind of dress, you can definitely layer this dress over a tank top or a t-shirt or long sleeve tee, leotard. You can just layer it over anything. So I'm just pushing it down and smoothing it out. And then I'm going to go around and see if any pieces are loose, if it lifts anywhere. So I found a piece here, and I'm just going to add a little more glue. Found another spot where the ear was loose, so I'm adding a little more glue there. So now we have our Minnie Mouse head attached, but it's not really Minnie until we add her bow. So next we're going to add her bow to the dress. And I already made her bow earlier and set it to the side. So there it is. I just need to decide where to put it. I actually liked it better to the side. I don't know why I didn't glue it there, but in any case, the way that you attach it is that you use hot glue, of course. And you just add a little dab of hot glue to the back. And stick it right where you'd like it to go. Now, I could stop there, but I decided that I wanted to add white polka dots to the skirt to make it more mini. So I've got some white felt there. You could use a template to cut out perfect circles, but I decided to just eyeball it, and I was cutting too much felt there, so I had to break that up. And I have some little circles, and you just attach these to the dress by using hot glue. You can just hot glue these right to the skirt. If you make sure you're just gluing to the top layer, it won't affect the bounciness of the skirt at all. And there is the finished look.